is over. Teams at full strength. Up the middle it goes. Voracek breaks to the net. Saved by Lundqvist. Out in front, Reed shot it wide with an empty net. That puck to the side of the net. Here's Voracek. Stopped by Lundqvist and Zuccarello. Wow, what a wild sequence.
Yeah, Voracek came off the Flyers bench for that breakaway. What a couple of saves by Lundqvist and some help from Claude.
Zuccarello trying to play it. Flyers with 54 points. Takeaway, Zuccarello shoots, save Mason. Oh, good chance off the Flyers turnover.
That was White that had the puck stolen by Zuccarello, and good save by Mason.
McDonough for the remainder of the game. There's a pass in front and a big chance and a save. Cousins got a chance. Rangers are called for hooking. Cousins broke in, was stopped by Lundqvist.
Boy, that all happened from the other end of the ice. The Flyers move the puck quickly. Up, they turn the quick puck movement into an odd man rush. Caught on the play. So just one defenseman back. You see Gandel rush in to try and make a play. He gets beaten on the play. So coming all the way back was Foss trying to catch up on the play. And the Rangers end up being shorthanded with Foss getting the hooking penalty.
Not playing White as tightly at the side of the net as they would Simmons. Now that's just been the shot. Redirection score, Ryan White. Just like that. And the power play gives the Flyers the 1-0 lead. Maybe they should pay more attention to it. So the Flyers power play now has tallied in 7 straight games.
And Gostis Bear with such an intelligent play at the point, finding the lane to get the shot through. Fakes the pass, moves his feet, and gets that shot to the net. White and Shen both there. Looks like Ryan White got a piece of it.
Yeah, just a great play by Gostis Bear, going from his left back to right. Totally fooled Tanner Glass, and somehow Lundqvist leaky finds a 5-hole. I don't think it hits Ryan White. I think that might be ghost goal, but Ryan White provides that for sure. I think it went right in, guys.
Nice one off his skate.
At 14:05, team skating for a side. Giroux takes it away from Klein. Giroux moves in, Girardi gets over, and Girardi with a hit just as Giroux released the shot. Big play.
Now that's the problem with Klein. You're down to 5 defensemen. He's got that brace on his thumb. Makes it difficult to handle the puck. And he was all alone when he just misplayed the puck. And that allowed Drew to pick it up and go down the other way for the chance.
Teams played toward the net. Score! Chris Kreider with a deflection in front. The shot by Girardi. The deflection by Kreider. The Rangers tie it at 1.
Now Steve Mason, an easy second period. And Kreider was well out on this deflection. Great job by Zuccarello to keep the play alive. And that shot, yeah, he wasn't all that far off. By mistake, I thought he was off further. But that shot would have gone wide on the short side. And Kreider, what a deflection that was. On his backhand side over the opposite shoulder of Mason, and the Rangers have tied it.
White, the puck deflects to Vandevelde, and now Cousin, or Gostis Bear, I should say, 53, not 52, to White, and the shot, he scores! Ryan White! The Flyers back on top, 2-1. It is not White's second of the game. They actually changed the first goal right before the period began, but this one, most definitely Ryan White's, and the Flyers have the lead back.
Gostis Bear returns the favor to Ryan White, sets him up on that goal after the saves at one end of the ice. The Rangers scrambling it around the Flyers net, and some help from Lawton and Medvedev kept it out of the net. Send it down the other way for the goal right there. Perfect pass to White, who snaps it past Lundqvist.
And we've seen a Henrik Lundqvist in the 2 goals today, guys. You usually don't see go in on him. That one right there, short side. Good quick release by Ryan White was what confused Lundqvist. The Flyers regained a lead. That's a huge goal.
Boyle looking for an opening. Out to Yandle for the one-timer. He scores! with 12.9 seconds to go. The Rangers have tied it.
Sam, the Flyers did not put any pressure on the Rangers in the offensive zone. They allowed the Rangers to keep making plays around the outside, electing to try and block shots instead of pressuring. Watch, even here, look at all five of them. They stay there. They stay there. No pressure. And so the Rangers now can move it. Boyle does a nice job. And eventually that long shot by Yandle beats Mason, who didn't see it. So no pressure from the Flyers, and the Rangers take their time. They show good patience. And then the shot by Yandle, the partial screen by Raffle. Mason doesn't see it. There's the reaction of the Rangers bench. And they tie it with just under 13 seconds to play.
For the Rangers, he's 2 for 4 in shootouts. Swings wide, cuts in, and scores! What a move by Matt Zuccarello!
Normally, Zuccarello comes from the right side when he's taking the penalty shot or straight down. This time he goes left. Fake one way and gets Mason to move and just reaches around him. What a goal. Beautiful goal by Zuccarello.
Win it for the Rangers. Stepan swinging wide, moves in, scores, and the Rangers win! What a win for the New York Rangers. Down 2-1 with only seconds remaining in regulation. The Rangers tied it on the goal by Keith Yandle. They win it in the shootout and pick up 2 huge points in the standings.
Deliberate was Derek Stepan. We've seen this before where he goes up and over the shoulder. He does. The goaltender, Mason, came way out, but by the time this shot was taken, he's back in the blue. There's room above that right shoulder, and the Rangers, after being outchanced and giving up 20 shots in the second period, come back in the third period, find a way to tie it, and then win it.
Rangers defeat the Flyers 3-2, winning 2-0 in the shootout, and we'll be back in just a moment.